Welcome to 5 Minutes in the Word, a daily devotional in the Word of God. Logan, in the Old Testament, you had a position, that was the high priest. And the high priest was someone that was their religious leader in that land or in that place. And they were the one that would be offering the sacrifices and the people would go to, especially for their atonement. And you see this high priest that is supposed to be this really religious leader, but he's also a mere man. Mm-hmm. He was mortal, so he made mistakes, just like the rest of us do. But when you come to the New Testament, you know, the Old Testament has been fulfilled, has been completed, yeah, in Christ Jesus. It talks about a new high priest, and this high priest is going to be better. In fact, the book of Hebrews talks about so many ways in which Jesus is better. So why don't you tell us a little bit about Jesus being our high priest?
Well, really what we should focus on today comes from chapter 4 of Hebrews.
Okay.
Starting in verse 14, since then we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our confession. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect has been tempted as we are, yet without sin. Let us then with confidence draw near to the throne of grace that we may receive mercy and find grace in the time of need. So just recently, Derek, the kids and I had a devotional, and then after that devotional, they were just firing off questions. I guess some of them were just half-hearted, really, or just seeing if they could ask crazy questions. But one,
they're trying to stump you.
Yeah. But one question really is they asked about the placement of heaven in where is heaven? Where can we find it? But here in verse 14, it says that we have a great high priest who passed through the heavens. As we know in the old law, the high priest would go through different sections of the temple to get to the most holy place, the outer court, the holy place, and then finally the most holy place. Jesus, as our high priest, did the same thing. He passed through the heavens, three different areas. The atmosphere of earth being the earthly heavens where the birds and the planes fly. Next, the stellar heavens as outer space, and then finally, God's abode, the heaven that we think about. So, therefore, there's a connection there between Jesus, our high priest, and the high priest of the old law. Verse 15, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect has been tempted as we are, yet without sin. Of course, when the high priest of the old law would go in to make that atonement sacrifice, he was also making one for himself, because, like you said, he was a mere man, right, and he knew sin, even though he was in this great religious position. However, Jesus knew no sin. He was tempted as we are, right, as we all are, yet Jesus knew no sin. So that kind of would lead to an issue there. How is he going to do this? But finally, verse 16, let us then with confidence draw near to the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. The reason that we can do this, and the only reason possible that we can do this, is because Jesus, because of Jesus. And what happened when Jesus breathed his last? What happened to the temple veil?
It was torn.
Therefore, that was more or less an opening for us to be able to go to the throne ourselves, because Jesus is our high priest.
Yeah, and it's an amazing thing to have Jesus as our high priest. You know, there's so many things that I see. You know, you talked about, you know, the passing through the heavens. You know, I think about Jesus, the fact that he came from God, so through the heavens to us, mm-hmm, but then he also went back to God to sit on the throne. So he went back through the heavens to go back. And is there reigning forever. And that's just an amazing thing to think about. It's also amazing to think about that Jesus is going to come back one day, and we're going to be able to meet him in the clouds. That's just another thing, mm-hmm, about thinking about Jesus as our high priest. But, you know, as you said, the high priest, he sinned, and while he did go in to make atonement for the sins of mankind, and that's great, you know, he wasn't perfect. And he stumbled and he fell, and that's what we do. We stumble and we fall. But the great thing about us and about the high priest, at least we have, is our high priest, the sacrifice that he made it once for all. Mm-hmm. And that once for all sacrifice, it wasn't for his sins, but it was for ours.
Yeah.
And through obedience, we are able to come into him and to be into him. And he becomes, therefore, our high priest, who is able to sympathize. And that's not saying that the Old Testament high priest did not sympathize or show compassion towards the people that he was over, but because he wasn't perfect, the sacrifice he offered, it just wasn't good enough. It
yeah.
could not pay the price that needed to be paid. But Jesus, like you said, he was tempted, but Jesus didn't sin.
Mm-hmm.
But being tempted, therefore, through that, it made him able to sympathize with us. He understands we're human. He understands that we're men. He can sympathize with that and help be our, you know, mediator, mm-hmm. and help plead our case there before God. Now, lastly, we'll say this today. You know, we come there to verse 16. It says, "Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need." We can boldly approach the throne room of God. We can go before him. And we know that our high priest, Jesus Christ, is there. That he is ready and willing to forgive us. That through him, we can have grace, we can have mercy, we can have hope, we can have salvation. And that's a great thing that our high priest offers us.
We truly have it all with Jesus.